Right now, I am going to discuss about production of colloids. What is this? No, as I said earlier, lyophobic are relatively lesser stable than lyophilic. Why? A lyophobic colloid is stabilized by only charges in the fixed layer of solid particles. Whereas lyophilics are stabilized by two factors, solvation and charges both. So, by the addition of a salt which can be coagulated more easily, yes, lyophobic. Lyophobic is coagulated more easily by the addition of a salt than a lyophilic. But you know, when a lyophilic salt is added to a lyophobic, the coagulation of the lyophobic salt can be prevented. That's why lyophobic salts are called protective colloids. So these are protecting colloids for lyophobic. Okay, see, lyophobic salts can protect the lyophobic salts from the coagulation by the addition of ergolite. How they can protect? Lyophilic salt forms a protective layer around the lyophobic salt particles. So it forms a protective layer around the particles. In that way, it protects the lyophobic from the addition of the salt. Now, the power of this lyophilic salt to protect the lyophobic is expressed by a number called gold number. The power of a lyophilic, the protective power of, the protecting power of a lyophilic
the minimum mass of life.
fluorophilic salt in milligrams that can protect 10 ml of gold salt by the addition of 1 ml of 10% NaCl is called gold number. See the once again definition. The minimum mass of fluorophilic salt that must be added to 10 ml of gold salt to protect the coagulation by 1 ml of 10% is called gold number. So have you got the definition for gold number? Very, very, very important. It is the minimum mass of fluorophilic salt that must be added to 10 ml of gold salt to prevent its coagulation by the addition of 1 ml of 10% NaCl. Okay, so it is the definition. So gold number is, it is the amount of or mass of, it is the mass of lyophilic salt in milligrams, the mass of or minimum mass of lyophilic salt, minimum, it is the minimum mass of lyophilic salt in milligrams to protect protector 10 ml of gold salt. Gold salt is high for you. Protect 10 ml of gold salt by the addition of 1 ml of 10% NaCl aqueous solution. Okay. Now have you got the definition for gold number? Now gold number is the measure of the protective power of lyophilic salt. Okay, how the protective power and gold number are related? If to protect 10 ml of gold salt, if lyophilic salt required is more amount, that means the power of lyophilic is lesser. So if even with a small amount it protects the gold salt, then in case one, that collider, the lyophilic collider is having more protecting power. So these two are inversely proportional. Protecting power and gold number. Protecting power and gold number. These two are inversely proportional to each other. Protecting power. More the gold number, lesser the protecting power. Okay, let's see some examples for lyophilic which can protect gold salt. So for that, gelatin is having very least gold number. Its gold number value is 0.0052, 0.01. So this is gelatin's gold number value. Similarly, next, hemoglobin. For hemoglobin, the gold number value is 0.03 to 0.03 around. Next, egg albumin. Its gold number is 0.1 to 0.25. Gold number value I am writing. Next, potato starch. For potato starch, its gold number is 0 to 25, around 25. So, here for different lyophilic salts, I have given gold number values. Now, what is gold number order for this? GN means gold number, okay? Gold number order increasing now. So, which has the highest gold number? Potato starch. That means which has the highest protective power? See the relation. Protective power and gold number, how are they related? Yes, inversely. So, lesser the gold number, higher the protective power. So among the four nucleophilic colloids, gelatin is having the highest protective power. Whereas potato starch has the least because its gold number is very high. Okay, so gold number represents the protecting power of which one? Electrolyte or lyophilic or lyophobic? Yes, gold number represents the protecting power of lyophilic salt. Previously I have discussed the flocculation value. What is the flocculation value? Is the minimum concentration of electrolyte that can cause coagulation of a colloidal solution, that may be
lyophilic or lyophobic. Generally lyophobic only coagulated by the addition of salt easily, na? So flocculation value means it is the minimum concentration of electrolyte that causes coagulation of a colloidal solution in 2 hours duration. But the concentration of electrolyte must be in millimoles per liter. Okay, so flocculation value indicates what? Protecting power of the colloidal solution. Whereas this gold number flocculation value indicates the coagulating ability of the colloidal solution, coagulating ability of the salt. Flocculation value is for salt, gold number is for lyophilic. Got it? So let's see the flocculation value relation also here. Flocculation value is inversely proportional to coagulating power. If any salt is having more flocculation value, it has lesser tendency to coagulate the colloid. If any salt has lesser flocculation value, it has more tendency to coagulate. So don't confuse these two words. Flocculation value is used for the coagulating ability of the salt, whereas gold number is used for the protecting power of lyophilic salt. The protecting power of lyophilic salt is expressed by gold number. The coagulating tendency of an electrolyte is expressed by flocculation value. Got it? Now let's see how the problems are asked on gold number. So in a question, 10 ml of gold salt is given. 10 ml of gold salt. Okay. To this, 1 ml of 10% NaCl is added for the coagulation. Now to protect here, some 5 grams of lyophilic salt is required, lyophilic. Then what is gold number of this lyophilic salt? How to say? Check it once. 10 ml of gold salt, as per the definition, gold salt is 10 ml, okay. As per the definition, electrolyte is 1 ml of 10% NaCl, that is also okay. Now, if these two conditions are satisfied, then the mass of lyophilic added in milligrams is called gold number. But here, mass is given in grams. So convert it into milligrams. 1 gram equals to 5000 milligrams. So what is the gold number of this lyophilic salt? Yes, 5000. Why? Gold number must be in milligrams. But in the given question, mass of lyophilic salt that can prevent the coagulation is 5 grams. Convert the 5 grams into milligrams. 5 grams is equal to 5000 milligrams. So in that way. Okay. Similarly, see one more question. Here, instead of 10 ml, sometimes 100 ml will be given. Then how to find out gold number for this 100 ml of gold salt? Okay, so to this first calculate, 1 ml of 10% NaCl is added to 100 ml of gold salt. So for that 5 grams is required. So for 100 ml, how much is required? Yes, 5 grams. Then for 10 ml, how much is required? For 100 ml of gold salt, 5 grams of lyophilic is required. But as per the definition, 10 ml of gold salt, for the 10 ml of gold salt, how much weight of the lyophilic is required? Yes, 0.5 grams. Now convert this 0.5 grams into milligrams. How much? 0.5 grams equal to 500 milligrams. That's why the gold number is 500. So first, if a question is asked on a gold number, first we have to check whether NaCl is 1 ml of 10% NaCl or not. Similarly, lyophobic salt, that means gold salt, is 10 ml or not. If the gold salt is 10 ml, NaCl is 1 ml of 10% NaCl, then check the weight if expressed in gram, milligrams or not. If it is not given in milligrams, convert the given grams into milligrams, then automatically you will get the gold number. Okay, so this is about protection of colloids.